Welcome to the hydraulic press channel. Today we will find out which is the most dangerous thing to crush. And the idea is to crush something. For example, now we have bearing ball. And then we are going to have these ballistic gelatin blocks around the thing that is going to explode. And then we will just see how deep will the fragments will fly into the gelatin. And this is clear ballistic. It's a bit like ballistic gelatin, but you can reuse it many times. And we have shot with cannon and lot of stuff, so it isn't like completely new anymore. But I think it doesn't matter. And yeah, let's start with the bearing ball. Yep, and here we go. Oi. Yep, pretty good. Let's save the high speed and then have a look. It's really hard to say is there any penetration on the gelatin because the small sparks, they fly so fast. I think the bigger parts hit the gelatin, but I'm not sure are they fast enough. Yep, and since these are pretty dirty, it's hard to say if there is some like really small holes. But there isn't any major holes in any of these. And I think that the most of the energy on bearing ball goes to those small, really small, but really fast particles. And these bigger ones, these are not moving fast, so these are not like dangerous or like super dangerous. Of course, you can go blind or something like that, but they are not going to kill you. And then the blast shield. There isn't anything wrong with the blast shield. So I declare that the bearing ball is relatively safe to crush, but don't try this at home, especially without like proper blast shield. And regular thin blast shield is probably not enough. You need like really thick polycarbonate because these can fly fast if you have bad luck. But at least this time these were quite slow. Yep, and then the next one, giant marble ball. And this is a bit softer material, but it's much larger ball. So I think in this time we could have more of energy going into those big clumps that can penetrate the gelatin. So let's see. And here we go. Oi. Wow. We might have some results now. At least it's like sticking to the gelatin. Yep, so here is the slow motion. Oh, looks pretty nice. And there is some movement on the gelatin. I'm not sure if those are fast enough or sharp enough. Yeah, I play it now a bit slower. So there is pretty big parts going and it looks like they like stick to the thing. They are not going to go super deep, but I think that would like hurt. This is so small particles that I think they are like just sticking to this, but they have not penetrated. Yeah, so I think we are on the right tracks, but still too small particles and too slow moving. And these are also much lighter than the steel particles. So I declare that this is about as dangerous as the bearing ball. Yep, and then the next one, big ball bearing, the whole thing, balls and the frame and everything. And last time when we crushed these, they were a bit smaller and they went quite deep into the gelatin. So I think this one can be first of the like truly dangerous crashes today. Yep, and here we go. Yeah, interesting. Yeah, looks like that this is the most dangerous so far. The shrapnel goes quite deep inside of the gelatin, but they still fly out. But that was the outer ring, and the inner ring, that's much tougher. And I'm going to remove the balls, and then we are going to crush that one, and I think it's going to be pretty bad. Yep, so the inner ring, it's a bit thicker and it's smaller, so it's much stronger. So it's going to take a lot more of energy to crush it, and therefore the shrapnel should be flying much faster. So let's see. And here we go. No! Yep, that didn't look bad. But here we have, this is new, and there is some. So you would probably bleed, but not like deadly. And then this one, here is something like this, and that's actually like maybe 1 centimeter deep. So yeah, so the whole bearing is more dangerous than just the balls. And I can show this. These are the stuff that is flying, so it's like really sharp. Yep, so the next one is IKEA Pokal like drinking glass. And these are stupidly strong. They can take well over 50 tons of force to crush. And we once crushed one like as a calibration piece for high speed camera. And it was like really bad surprise for everyone how loud and violent it was. So let's see how it goes this time. Yep, and here we go. Yeah, I think that was like the largest bang so far. Yep, so this is one of the pieces that flying out. And here is the line that was the bottom of the glass, which exploded really fast. And the particles are really tiny. But this is like, it's like full of like, it's like the texture of the surface is now completely different. There is was like this really really fine sand flying really fast. So I think it wouldn't like penetrate your skin. Probably make it like red or something like that. But that's quite strong glass. It was huge bang. Yep, and then the last one, playing cards. And these are not very heavy or sharp, but they take over 100 tons of force, and it's always huge explosion. So I think we could have some cards sticking into the gelatin. And here we go. Oh, it's going to be really bad. Yeah, I go have a look. Yeah, these are like completely full of like 1 millimeter deep holes and lot of stuff, so it's really hard to say, but I think the playing cards like this, they are so tiny, like kind of this, that this is not going to like penetrate. I have been once hit by flying pulp from the machine, and it leaves like just like reddish mark to your skin, and I think this is quite the same thing. So it's going to hurt, but it's not like dangerous. All of these were just like one go. If you try again, it could be completely different. And it always is really dangerous to use this much of force. So even if this looks quite safe now, it could be really dangerous. So don't try this at home. And I have a couple things that are even more dangerous than things that we did today. But those need a little bit more like planning to do them safely. So if you liked this video, please hit thumbs up. And if this gets a lot of views, then we do that little bit extra work and came up something even more stupid next week. Yeah, but I think that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. And for today's extra content, we have this green blizzard. It looks really harmless, but it might have nasty surprise in it. So it is extremely dangerous and we have to deal with it.